Hi, welcome to a new video. As you can see, we're still wearing the same clothes as probably the last one we posted.
Or we might be wearing the same clothes in the next one. We don't know.
Or it's a different day and we just happen to look exactly the same.
And it's also dark.
You don't know.
We're also
magic
in my house.
Today we're going to talk about the importance of going to practice.
Yeah.
We'll keep it brief, but to the point.
Yes.
That's a lie. We're not going to keep
we're
it.
We're not. Let's be honest.
We're just going to talk.
45
These are
later.
Long. You don't know it, but I cut it down into something that is consumable.
Yeah, the importance of going to practice. I mean, we all know, we're all grown-ups here. We all know that practice makes you better. And with roller derby, I think it's really important because it is a full contact sport, first of all.
Yeah.
So you've got to know who you're playing with and how to fall.
Yeah, if you don't practice, you are so much more susceptible to injury.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line. You're going to get hurt if you're not showing up to practice.
As, I'm part of the training committee for our league. And yeah, that's really tough to the training committee doesn't do...
I helped.
Thank you. The training committee doesn't just show up. Like, we have meetings and we discuss who's going to be... running practice, and then those trainers take time out of their week to plan a practice. And we always plan the practice with the idea that there's gonna be 14, 15, 16
yes.
people there, because we want to be able to run drills that are scrimmages and, you know, that we can do multiple lines with and things like that.
Working as drills that make you work as a team.
Yeah.
And when your team's not there, it's very difficult to do that. And then when you get to a game, you've got members of the team that just kind of are, I don't know.
Yeah.
And I think one of the big reasons we succeeded so well this year is that people were showing up.
Yeah, we had a really good attendance this year.
And we're really starting to gel and figure each other out. And that only happens. You can't just know.
No.
You've had, some players, they play with each other for 8 years. They don't see each other for 6 months. They play together again.
Yeah.
They know how each other plays.
Yeah.
But that takes time, and practice is time.
And also, it helps you get more in shape, too, right? Like, not everybody works out outside of derby, which I thoroughly 100% think that you should. I believe that you need to make the rest of your body stronger and better in order to do well in derby.
Off skates is going to change your game significantly.
Yes.
Especially with derby, when, you know, if you skate in a certain way, you're using kind of one side a lot.
Yes.
So you want to be trying to counterbalance a little bit and working on other things, because you use a very specific muscle set to play roller derby and you still need to be attacking those other muscles you're not using.
Yeah, exactly.
And we, as a league, we totally understand some people, it's difficult. They've got jobs, they work till, we have practice at 7 or 7 or
7
8.
7 or 8, yeah.
And 7 is a little bit tight.
Yeah.
Because some people don't, I don't get done work till 5:30. So I'm even for me, I'm hustling out the door.
Yeah. And some people are single parents, and some people have other spouses or whatever that work shift work or get called out or whatever. And I totally get that. That's I'm not totally at all bashing anybody who can't make practice every single time, because we don't make practice every single time.
And I think what we're really, the people we're pinpointing is the ones that wake up. They go to work and they come home and I'm just dead tired. I just would rather stay home and curl up on the couch.
Yeah, we all would.
We all would. And I think that's the time to say, no, I'm going to go to practice.
Yeah.
Because that's where you're going to start to see a change, is making the decision when you really don't want to go.
Yeah.
That's a big one.
Yeah. Oh yeah, for sure. And the amount of times that I've been in that headspace, I've been on my feet all day, the kids were running me ragged, whatever, there's dishes to be done, whatever. I'm looking at my kitchen right now going, there's dishes to be done, but but 9 times out of 10, my husband will say, go to practice, just get out of here. Because he knows that I need it, and I appreciate that about him.
Yes.
Yeah.
But anyway, we're going to wrap this up because my battery's dying.
Yeah. Also, practice helps for your refs and NSOs, too.
Yes, bring them along.
Bring them along to your practices, because nothing is better for a ref or an NSO than practice.
It is very true. In the comments below, tell us, I don't know what to tell us. What should we tell them to tell us?
What's your favorite thing about practice?
Or what's your best way to overcome I don't want to go to practice?
Yeah. Yeah, both of those things.
Either or.
Write those things.
Dealer's choice.
Yeah.
But anyway, thank you so much for watching.
We'll see you next time.